We thank you, Father, for everything that you have done, continue to do in each of our lives. How you kept us, how you protect us, how you direct us, how you lead us and direct us. And Father, we thank you, Lord God. You are a faithful God. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you know the needs of your people tonight, those who is here and those who is watching this broadcast. We thank you, Lord God, that you speak to each of our hearts in the name of Jesus, and that we are your sheep, we hear your voice, and we follow your direction. And Father, we lift unto you, Lord God, Pastor Larry, and as he come and ministering to us, Lord God, we ask you, Lord God, that you use him as your instrument, as your vessel, Lord God. Speak for him in Jesus' name. And Father, we're giving you a praise, and we're giving you a glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, have your way, Holy Spirit, in this place. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Well, God bless you. You may have a seat in the presence of the Lord. God is the faithful God. Amen. He concerned about everything what you dealing in your life. But we know as we yield to him and as we hear his voice, he will direct us. He will lead us. In the midst of troubles, in the midst of situations, God will always give us a way to escape. He will always open the door for us. And it seems sometimes like, oh, I don't know what, how God gonna do it. But through our faith, by faith, it's gonna manifest. The scripture says, have faith, right?
Yes.
So we receive and we have the faith. And the faith and the living God, and faith that God is the bigger, he is the mighty, that any situation or any circumstances in each of our lives, the God who we serve, he is the big God, he is the mighty God, he is the powerful God. Hallelujah. Before Pastor Larry come and ministering to us, I wanted to pray for you, those who is here and those who is watching this broadcast, that God will show himself strong on each of our behalf. Amen. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, I lift unto you, Lord God, every person who is here and those who is watching this broadcast. Lord, I ask you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you will comfort your people, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, that you strengthen your people, Lord God. I ask you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, let the impartation of your anointing be imparted up in the people right now, in the name of Jesus. That your anointing, burden removed, yoke destroyed, power of God will manifest in the name of Jesus. We bind every demonic assignment to come against God's people right now. We break it off right now in Jesus' name. And Father, we thank you, Lord God. We're giving you a praise for the breakthroughs. Hallelujah. And if you're here tonight, or those who is watching this broadcast, and you need that supernatural breakthrough, just expect. Expect and proclaim with me and declare in the name of Jesus, I call it in the breakthroughs in my life. I call it in the mountains be moved. The destructions be moved in the name of Jesus. And Father, we call him in. Breakthrough, breakthrough, breakthrough. And God's people. And Father, we thank you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for supernatural intervention. For supernatural guidance and direction, Lord God. Every decision that your people will make, let the decisions be according to your will and according to your purpose. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that the eyes of understanding of your people will be enlightened, that they will know the hope and the call in their lives. And every decision they will make, let be according to your will. And Father, we break Every confusion, we break it off right now in Jesus' name. And Father, we're giving you a praise. We thank you for it. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Just keep rejoicing in the Lord. But God is good. Rejoice in all the times. When it's good. And when it's a different situation. Because God who you serve, He is the faithful God. The God who you serve, nothing is impossible with Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. I wanted to read right now, and many of you know that scripture. Hallelujah. In the book of Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord. The thoughts of peace and not of evil. To give you expectant end. Hallelujah. Then look at this in verse 12. Then shall you call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. Hallelujah. And you shall seek me and find me, when you shall search for me with all of your heart. Hallelujah. And I will be found of you, says the Lord, and I will turn away your captivity, and I will gather you from all the nations. See, God promised to us that His promise, that whatever captive you, whatever you're going through, whatever holds in you back.
Come on,
yeah. Hallelujah. God promised to each of us that He will deliver you, that He will set you free. And you know what? Bible is also telling us that He will be the enemy to our enemies. Hallelujah. But see, when we have this relationship with our Heavenly Father, when we have this relationship with our God, oh, when He is dwelling in us and you, and you dwell in Him, see, you become one. You become one. And the work what Jesus Christ did in this earth, that you should do also. See, the power is in us. The power is in you. So the enemy, he come to bring the destruction, and he tried to shake your faith. But see, when you just rejoice in the Lord, and you say, ha ha, Satan, you under my feet. I am walking in a victory. I am walking in the victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. That we have to learn how to be overcome the enemy. See, the victory is already ours. But we need to learn how to walk in that victory. Hallelujah. Well, today is the topic, and Pastor Larry is always teaching on Tuesday night, is the spiritual warfare. Okay? So we're in spiritual warfare, and God give us the power and authority to walk in a victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. And we have to understand that we're not going against the flesh and blood. We're not going against your neighbor, your cousin, or whoever. We go against the principalities, powers, rules of darkness. What behind the person, not the person, what behind the person. And God, He will give you a victory in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, God bless you. Pastor Larry is here. He's going to minister to us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Glory. Sound like I'm a little hot up here. The number one over there, all the way across. Can you check it out? Test 1, 2. Okay, that's better. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. How you doing, sister? Long time no see.
I'm okay.
That's a good thing.
I made it here.
That's a good thing. You right where you're supposed to be right now. Mm-hmm. Amen. And I thank God that you're still with us. Amen. A lot of people had a visitation over the years, and they have graduated from this earthly kingdom. Thank God for those that are still here. They're going to get to experience something like they never experienced before. They're going to have opportunity. Be quiet. I'm talking. Amen. I don't know where everybody else is. That's okay. That's right. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. God bless you all. And Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you for this service tonight, Lord. We ask you in the name of Jesus that you will show yourself strong on our behalf, that you will move by the power of your Spirit in a supernatural way. Open our eyes of understanding that we will know what is the hope of your calling, what is the exceeding greatness of your power toward us who believe according to the workings of your mighty power. Father, we thank you and we give you all the glory because, God, we know that in our own self, in our own strength, in our own ability, we can't do nothing. But it's in you, Lord, that we live and move and have our being. So, Father, we trust you. We honor you. We exalt you. We declare that your kingdom come, your will be done in earth as it is in heaven. We release, Father, your anointing, your presence in this place right now. We bind every demonic force that is not of you, Lord God. We loose it from its assignment right now. We apply the blood of Jesus over every heart, every soul. And God, we declare today is today that you have made. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. Father, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. And today we will walk in the power of your strength. Oh, glory to God. We bless you and we glorify you, Father. Now, Father, I ask you that you would anoint every ear to hear, prepare every heart to receive. Make my tongue as of a pen of a ready writer to write your word upon the hearts and upon the mind of your people, that they will know the truth and that the truth shall make them free. And, Father, we give you all the glory, honor, and praise in advance. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Well, glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah. So glad to see all of you guys coming out tonight. Amen. Because you could have been anywhere else, but God brought you here. Amen. Go ahead with that back there, honey. Amen. I'm gonna sing a song tonight. Amen. And I pray that it'll be a blessing to you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Sometimes you just have to be still and let God have his way. Stop trying to push yourself and just rest in him. Thank you, Lord. I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. When this old world tried to push and shove me, I need to be still and let God love me. I need to relax. Let God take over. I need to relax and let God take over. He'll take his load off of my shoulder. I need to relax and let God take over. When troubles all around me, when my soul cries out for rest, when I feel
decisions get so heavy, and there's answers that I need. I know it's time to just be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. When this old world tried to push and shove me, I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. I need to be still and let God love me. When this old world tried to push and shove me, I need to be still and let God love me.
We choose to be still. Amen. Hey, hon. Number three. All the way over. Number three. Pull it down just a little bit. Number three. You got it? All the way across. Minds. Now turn it off. Number three. On the bottom. All the way across to the other side. That side over there. You know my mic? Number one is my mic. Number three, yeah. Pull number three down, sir. Thank you. A little bit more. A little bit more. No, it can't be over there because you gotta put the echo there. Okay. Okay.
Let me handle it. Did you get it?
Should be fine now. God bless you.
God bless you.
God bless you too. Amen. We're going to have a little technical difficulties back there. That's my mic. Now, why is it doing that? Okay, that's better. No, it's getting like it was. Well, glory. It's okay now? Anyway, we're gonna go ahead on, and we're gonna believe that this stuff's gonna work. I might have to call and make some complaints. Amen. Anyway, this is spiritual warfare. I actually, you can see we are having a little warfare.
Right. Getting it out.
So it's not a false statement. It's a true statement. Amen. But I want you to prepare your heart, because I believe that God is going to speak to our hearts tonight, and I believe that everything that He intends for us to know and to understand is going to come forth. Amen. So just hold your horses. Amen. Just hold your horses, because I believe that we are in the right place at the right time. Hallelujah. So now, okay. Open your Bible with me to the book of Ephesians, chapter 6. Ephesians, chapter 6. Glory to God. And notice the Bible says right here in verse number 10. Ephesians chapter 6, verse number 10 says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might." Amen. Amen. "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might." Amen. Then he says, verse number 11 says, "Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." Amen. "Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God." "Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God." Amen. So I want to talk to you tonight, as we've been talking these last few days, about spiritual warfare. Now, during this season, we know that the days are getting darker. I'm not just talking about with the daylight and the sun and the night going, and the daylight coming to evening, and the evening coming to dusk dawn, then dusk dawn come to dark. I'm talking about spiritual darkness. Amen. Spiritual darkness. And everywhere you look around, you can see the enemy is working overtime, trying to manipulate, trying to control and try to take advantage of people that are without the knowledge to understand what's going on. And that's why he said, verse number 12, said, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers." See, these are not people that you might think that you are wrestling with or against. These are spiritual principalities and powers and the kingdoms of darkness. Amen. These are Satan's armies that are at war against us. And so what we need to know and to understand is that when we begin to experience difficulties in our life, we shouldn't look at trying to see, well, why is that person acting like this? Why is that person doing this? Why is that person doing this? Well, I never did anything to that person. It's not a person. It's not someone messing with you. It's the powers of darkness that's trying to interfere with your heart, with your mind, with your will, with your emotions to get you off guard. Amen. Because if he can get you off guard, he can take control of your mindset. Amen. God wants you to be strong in him and not in your own self. Because to be strong in your own self, that means you're not dependent on God. You're dependent on what you can accomplish yourself. Amen. You see, now the warfare that we face, these are spiritual beings. Just like you are a human being, these are spiritual beings. They are there, but you can't see them. And they will use even your loved ones to make you feel uncomfortable sometimes. You don't feel uncomfortable because someone got angry at you and you don't even know why they got angry with you? Amen. Because you're not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against principalities and against powers. Amen.
and against spiritual wickedness in high places. See, the wickedness that we are in, the wickedness that we are engaging, they have the ability to manipulate. They have the ability to cause you to stumble and fall. Like they can give you different images, different thoughts, and then next thing you know, your heart is caught up with this thing, and you're in trouble spiritually because you yielded to a spirit of deception. And some might call it an angel of light, because it was talking to you. And you thought that it was talking to God. You thought the Spirit of God was talking to you. But all the time it was a devil talking to you. A demon talking to you from the pits of hell. I've been there. I've heard those voices. That was many years ago, not now. I want to get that straight. That was many years ago, but not now. Amen. The voice I hear now is the Lord Jesus Christ, the Spirit of the living God. Amen. And this is the one God wants you to hear. Amen. This is the one God wants you to hear. But those things they seem so real. They seem so real. And it makes you think that someone is chasing you. Yeah. I've been there. And it make you feel like somebody's watching you every move you make. And so you have to understand that we are not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the dark of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. And he said, wherefore take unto you what?
The whole
armor of God.
Yeah.
The whole armor of God. Amen. Because we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers. Amen. And this is why God wants us to clothe ourselves with the whole armor. He don't want to depend upon our own abilities, our own strength. Because the moment you begin to depend upon your own abilities, your own strength, that's the moment you're gonna be caught up in this battle. That you've been caught. And the only battle you're supposed to be fighting in is the fight of faith.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
That's the only battle you're supposed to be engaged in faith. Amen. For the Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse number 3, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to what? To the pulling down of strongholds. Amen. We need to gird up our loins with the truth, because the truth is going to guide us. The truth is going to guide us in the way of the Lord. The truth is going to show us which way we should go, and how we should follow. Amen. Your situation, your circumstance is not as bad as you think. Amen. It's not as bad as you think. God wants you to see yourself as He has prepared you to be seen. God wants you to be seen as a child of God, not as the worldly child. Amen. God wants you to be caught up. He wants you to be changed in Him, transformed in Him. That's why He tells us in Romans chapter 12 and verse number 2, it says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. God wants to bring us to a stage of transformation. And how that's going to take place is by the Word. This Word will transform your heart. It will transform your mind. It will transform your thinking. It will cause you to see yourself as God sees you. And before you know it, your whole life, let me tell you something. Once you begin to allow the Word to transform you, your whole life going to begin to look different. People are going to look at you, and you went over there, you went to this store the other day, and your friend working over there, and that person been knowing you all your life. You went there last week, and everything was okay, everything was just normal. But you went to church on Sunday. And then after you left church, you went to that store again. But at church,
you had an experience. At church, you had a visitation. At church, you got born again. At church, you became a new creature, created in Christ Jesus unto good works. Now you go back to the store, and now you see your friend. Then that friend gonna look at you and say, "What happened to you? You don't look like the same person. You look different. What's going on?" And you trying to, they'd have caught you off guard now. Now you're trying to figure out, what is he talking about? but see, you are a different person. Mm-hmm. You've been translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his dear son. So before he saw you as he saw himself, a person of the world. So now when he sees you, because you became a born again child of God, amen, you've been translated from darkness to light. Now when he sees you, he sees a new person, and he don't understand this person. Amen. This is why it's so important that we understand that God wants us to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. Amen. Because when you renew your mind, your whole life is not, you won't get that kind of compliment just one time. You get that compliment everywhere you go. I don't know you, but I like what I feel around you. There's an aura around you. Ain't that what they call it? An aura? Amen. And they don't understand it, but it's the Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit. It's the presence of God. When did that come? It came the moment you gave your heart to the Lord with all sincerity. When you said, "God, regardless of what the world is saying, regardless of what I've done, regardless of what my family think, God, I surrender. I surrender my all to you." And once that decision is made, it gotta be a heart decision, not a mind decision, because you do it from your mind, it's only gonna last until you get out the door. But if it's from the heart, it's gonna not only last until you get out the door, somebody else is gonna know it too. Someone else is gonna know it too. They're gonna see it. They're gonna experience it. Why? Because your life is gonna begin to demonstrate the goodness of the Lord. Amen. And the presence of God. Amen. It's not just something that you're gonna experience one time. This is gonna be something that's gonna take place. This is something that's gonna work for you. This is something that's gonna show up and show out. Amen. You ever heard the word show up and show out? God is going to show up and show out on your behalf. Amen. Glory to God. That's why he wants to gird ourselves with truth. The first item that he tells us in Ephesians? He said, gird up your loins with what?
Truth.
With truth. With truth. Why? Because when you know the truth is going to do what? It's going to make you free. It's going to make you free. See, we walk around our whole life and not realizing that we've been in bondage our whole life. We walk around and we don't understand why this is not going right, why this is not going right, why my child is going through this, why my family is having so many issues. We're trying to figure out why all this is happening. And if you really look at it, it's because they've been interfered with by the kingdom of the darkness of this world. He's interfering with their life. He's manipulating them. He got them on a yo-yo. He's throwing them out, and when he get tired, when they come to his task, he'll bring them back in. Then when they something else, he'll throw them out in another direction. And when they come to his task, he'll reel it back in. Amen. You're just a person on a yo-yo string, and the devil is using you for his game. Amen. But God wants you to know the truth, because when you know the truth, amen, the truth is going to make you free. We must understand why the Roman soldiers, when they went out to battle, they didn't go out half dressed. They had their armor on. You remember David when he was going to go out and fight Goliath? Yeah. Saul tried to give him his armor because Saul had the best armor. And he tried to give David his armor. And David picked it up and tried to put it on. Oh, no, this is too heavy for me.
Too big.
I can't work with this. Amen. See, you got to understand your armor. Because God has equipped each and every one of you with your armor. You see, you can't use someone else's armor. No.
You got to use what God has given you. Because the weapons of your warfare are the ones that God's going to use to pull down the strongholds. The demonic strongholds that you are wrestling against, that you're fighting against, they're not in the physical realm. They're in your mind. They're in your mind. Amen. And if you allow the enemy to dominate your mind, then he's going to dominate your life. Ask Murphy, he'll tell you. He'll dominate your life. Amen. But thank God for the truth. Amen. Spiritual warfare is a something that we, as a child of God, we all need to be aware of. It's not every child of God is going through spiritual warfare, but somewhere in their life they're going to experience spiritual warfare. Amen. They're going to experience spiritual warfare. They're going to experience the demonic oppression coming against them. Amen. They're going to experience sickness and disease trying to overtake their bodies, and they hadn't even did nothing wrong. But it's the devil working against them. See, the Bible says in John 10:10, said the thief comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He said, but I come that you might have life, and that you may have it more abundantly. You see, no matter what side of the street you was born on, it doesn't matter even what city you was born in, it doesn't even matter how much education you have. But if you've been born again, you become a prime target for the enemy, because he want to put your lights out. And he's going to take your family, your children, your husband, your wife. He's going to do everything he can to eliminate you, to make you void and useless. My God. Amen. And I know, if you've never been through something like that, just say, friends, you married, all of a sudden you married, and you come home from work one day, you done did everything, and your spouse done had dinner ready for you, you think that everything is all right, and then there's a knock on the door. And he said, somebody at the door, honey, can you go to the door? And then you go to the door, open up the door, hello, can I help you? And he said, here you go right here. Then he said, then once it's in your hand, he drops his hand and said, you've been served. All right. Can you imagine what a heart will go through when they experience something like that? Yeah, it's just like all hell to just open up against you. Amen. And now you don't know what to think. You don't know what to do. And now you're trying to figure out, why is this happening? And it's all because someone had yielded to, maybe you might call it a familiar spirit, or you might call it a spirit of a what? No, it's all spiritual warfare, but it's another spirit that I'm trying to think of right now. He's not the spirit of rejection. That's part of it too. But it's the familiar spirit. Familiar spirit. Amen. And that thing, it followed you all your life. And finally you're getting your life on the right track. And the only way he can stop you from moving forward is to tear your heart out of your chest. So he's going to rip the very thing that you love the most. He's going to rip it away from you. Then all of a sudden, your whole life is going to shatter. You're going to find yourself falling back to that old pattern, that old life, because you're hurting so much. You're trying to figure out how you're going to cope with life now, what you're going to do. Then all of a sudden, you get strung out on the same drug, alcohol, club life, and everything that you were doing before you got saved. And now you go back to that life. Now you're starting to hear voices. You're starting to hear things now, because now he's got you in his trap, and now he's trying to destroy your mind. He's going after your mind, amen. So we have to understand. That's why he said, "Be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Amen. Because if your mind is renewed, no matter how strong that enemy beat against you, no matter how many times he robbed you of your loved ones, your heart is not going to give in, because you know exactly where all this is coming from. You're not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world. And that's why you must know the truth. Because if you don't have no truth in you, you don't have no foundation to stand on. That's right. Mm-hmm. Say that. Mm-hmm. Because when that door opened and they give you that paper, and all of a sudden, your whole life, everything that you was living for, has been taken away from you. Then all of a sudden, you back off into a corner and you start sobbing, crying, trying to figure out what happened, what did I do? Spirit of grief. Mm-hmm. And that devil gonna play with your head, gonna play with your heart, gonna play with your mind like never before. Amen. But God, who is rich in mercy for his great love, wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sin, had quickened us together with Christ. For by grace are you saved. Through faith, not of works, lest any man should boast. God is bringing us to a position. God is bringing us to a position of knowing. God is bringing us to a position of knowing. Amen. He wants you to know who you are. He wants you to know your position. He wants you to know that he's for you. Amen. He wants you to know that he's for you. Glory to God. The Bible tells us in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5. Yeah. Verse number. Let me just turn on it right now. 1 Peter 5. Are y'all going over there with me? You already there? Mm-hmm. Okay, that's good. But I'm getting there. I'm there. 1 Peter 5. There we go. Look at verse number 7. Yep. Cast all your care upon him. See, you got to understand, when God is asking you to cast all your care upon him, he's not asking you that for his purpose. No. Yep. He's asking you that for your purpose. Because he knows what you're going through. He knows the struggles that you are facing. He knows the condition of your heart. And he knows what the enemy has planned for you. That's why God doesn't want you to try to fight this battle in your own strength. That's why he said, cast all of your care. Where? Upon him. Why? Because he cares for you. Amen. And then notice what he said, verse number 8. He said, be sober. Be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. Now get this, folks. This last part is very powerful. It's very simple, but it's very powerful too. He said, whom resist what?
Steadfastness
in the faith.
Yes.
Amen. God wants you to hold fast. Amen. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walking about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Who resists steadfastness in the faith? That the same affliction are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. Amen. So the people of the world, they're going to go through these things. And you know what they do when they go through these things? Most of them, they go find a high building and they jump. Suicide. Because they don't know how to cope with it. This is why God wants you to have an understanding of the truth. Because once you have an understanding of the truth is going to build a foundation in your heart so that you can have a something that you can reflect back upon. Amen. Relate to. Because if you don't have something that you can relate to, if there's no one in your life that you can bring this issue to and talk to them about, amen, then you are going to be just like those people that are without hope. You're going to go and find yourself a bridge. Or you're going to find a tall building. You're going to try to get up on it. Or you might even go into a busy street and just take a step. You see, God is not going to allow you to be tempted more than you can bear. And that's why you must have a foundation of the word in you. God wants you to know that he has given you everything that you need to withstand the powers of darkness. He said in Luke chapter 10, verse number 19, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread over serpents and over scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy." And he said that nothing shall by enemies hurt you. In other words, God doesn't want you to be afraid. He doesn't want you to be afraid to stand firm. He doesn't want you to be scared to hold your ground. He wants you to see yourself as he sees you. And he sees you as a conqueror. He sees you as someone that's important. Amen. Paul said it this way. When Paul clothed in Christ righteousness, you can live in the 100% victory over the powers of darkness. Look what Paul says right here in Galatians chapter 1. In Colossians chapter 1, I mean. Mm-hmm. Colossians chapter 1. And look at verse number 20. Colossians chapter 1, verse number 20. It said, "And having made peace through the blood of the cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven, and you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in the mind by wicked works, yet now had he reconciled." Yet now he had reconciled. Amen. See, God knows exactly where you are. Jesus is working on your behalf to bring you into perfect harmony with himself and with the Father. Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm. With himself and with the Father. "For this purpose the Son of God was manifest," the Bible said, "to destroy the works of the devil." Amen. You have an opportunity to be strong in the Lord than you've ever been in all your days. God has given you, amen, not all attacks of the enemy are going to be able to overcome you. They might hit you strong, they might hit you hard, but that don't mean they're going to overtake you. Because as the day goes by and as the time goes on, God in that time is giving you strength. He's strengthening you because you've been talking with him, you've been spending time with him, you've been seeking his face, you've been spending time in the word, and you've been praying to him. You've been communicating with him, and now God, he sees that your heart is being turned back toward him. So God is right now, he began to quicken your mortal body to bring you back into alignment to what he called you to walk in from the beginning. And the devil said, "No." Because you see, if the devil can stop you, he would have a long time ago. That's why I like what it says in Joshua chapter 1, verse number 8. He said, "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. And then thou shalt have what?
Good
success." You want to be a success in your Christian walk? Meditate on the law. Meditate on the law. And he tells us again in Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20. He said, "My son, attend to my words, incline thy ear to my saying." Amen. "Let them not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart. For they are life to those that find them and health to all their flesh." Amen. See, God knows that as we adhere to the word is going to give us the stability that we need to endure. Endure. Amen. See, Christ in in you is the hope of glory. We are to be, God wants us to clothe ourselves with the whole armor, not part of it, so that when the enemy come against you, he won't see you. He'll see Christ in you. He'll see Christ in you. Amen?
Amen.
Glory to his name. See, when we gird about ourselves, when they said, then he wants to put on a breastplate of righteousness. He wants to put on a breastplate of righteousness. Why? Because as we put on a breastplate of righteousness, we're not gonna give it to seducing spirit. Because a seducing spirit is not gonna teach you, it's not gonna point you in the way of righteousness. It's gonna point you in the way of the world. So if you put on your robe of righteousness, and then when the enemy come against you, your walk is gonna be. The Bible says like this. His word shall be a lamp to your feet and a light to your path.
Amen.
Amen. See, now because you're walking in righteousness, your path is lit up. Why? Because you're walking God's way. You're walking the way that God intended for you to walk. And now your path is lit up. And now, what's going to happen now? That the Spirit of God, he's going to lead you. And he's going to guide you into what? All truth. He's going to lead you and guide you into all truth. And then he's going to do what? He's going to show you what? Things to come. You want to know what's coming up next in your life? Then let your life come in alignment with the word of God. He will guide you into all truth and he will show you things to come. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so that's why I'm so excited about this. Now, while I'm over here, let's go back to Colossians again. Because, you see, Colossians is a very powerful chapter here, especially chapter 2. It's a very powerful chapter, where the whole Bible is very powerful. But, you know, there's some parts that you can really identify with. Mm-hmm. Amen. Then there are some parts that you have to just meditate on until you get till you have a better understanding of it. Mm-hmm. Glory to God. But the reason why I like right here, because I see right here that Jesus, he did something that was so important. Look at verse number 15, chapter 2, verse number 15. Let's start verse number, oh my God,
this is all so good. Woo. Oh my God.
Oh God, yes, okay. Let's look at verse number six. Now he brought me all the way back up here. Amen. But notice what he said right here. Verse number six says, as ye have therefore what? Received Christ Jesus the Lord. As ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord. He said, so walk ye in him. Amen. So walk ye in him. Then verse number 7 says, rooted, built up in him, established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abiding therein, mm-hmm. with thanksgiving. Amen. Mm-hmm. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, mm-hmm. after the tradition of what? Of men, and after the remnant of the world, and not after Christ. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. And ye are complete in him, which is the head of all principalities. Notice what he said now, which is the head of all principalities and power. See, we're abiding in Christ. When we're abiding in Christ, remember our seating arrangement in Ephesians chapter 2 and verse number six, he said, and has raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Then you look at Ephesians chapter 1, verse number 21, said, far above all principalities and powers and mighty dominion. So God has raised us up. He has given us everything that we need to withstand the kingdom of darkness and to take a bold stand in this earth today. God has given us everything we need. Now notice what he said right here again. Verse number 10, and ye are complete in him. He said, you are complete in him. Amen. Amen. Which is the head of all principalities and powers, in whom also ye were circumcised with the circumcision made without hand, and in putting off the body of sin, and putting off the body of sin of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism, wherein also ye are raised with him through the faith of the operation of God, who had raised him from what?
From the dead.
From the dead. Who had raised him from the dead, and you being dead in your sins and in circumcision of your flesh, had he quickened together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses. Having forgiven you all trespasses. Verse number 14, we're getting down now where it's going to really, where it's going to really stand out to us now. Verse number 14 says what? And blotting out the handwritings of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to the cross. Amen. Nailing it to the cross. Look at verse number 16 says, verse number 15 says, verse 15 says, and having spoiled principalities and powers. Now, I like that part because, you see, if Jesus has spoiled principalities and powers and you are complete in him, don't you know that you have the ability in you? This is not something you got to go and try to find. It's already in you.
Yes, amen.
It's in you. You can withstand the kingdom of darkness as you stand on the word of God. This is why you've got to have a foundation of the word on the inside of you. It's so important. To have a foundation of the word on the inside, because you see, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, and against the rulers of the darkness of this world, and spiritual wickedness in high places. Verse number 15 points it out very clear to us. It says, this is Colossians chapter 2, verse number 15, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, trampling over them in it. Amen. Then he said, let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, or in respect of holiday. Holy day or whatever. But God don't want you to get involved in the religious standpoint of this thing. He wants you to understand the power that he has given you as a child of God to stand against these things. But so often we revert back to our religious part of our bringing up. And when we do that, we find ourselves getting caught up in the things of the past. And when you get caught up in the things of the past, you're going to start remembering the things of the past. And then all of a sudden, you're not just going to remember those things of the past. You're going to start finding yourself involved in those things again. Remember what God did for you? He translated you from the kingdom of darkness. He didn't just snatched you out. He translated you. It was a spiritual transformation that took place in your life. And he did it, why? Because he loved you. Yeah. He could have just left you there. He could have looked at you and said, you ain't no but old nasty worm. I don't want you in my kingdom. But no, he didn't do nothing like that. He looked at you and said, I created you in my image and after my likeness, and I will not abandon you. Even though I see you are having difficulties following my wishes, following my judgment, following my commandments, yet will I not abandon you. I will give you opportunity after opportunity. Every time you fall, I will pick you up because I want you to know how much you mean to me. Oh, glory to God. Oh, I felt that. Hallelujah. Whew. Glory to his name. See, sometimes you fall, you don't realize that you're down for the count. But then God, before he hit that last number, before he hit that number, before he hit that 10, he done got you back up again. And you back up walking. You ready to go again. And why that? Because he loved you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I like that part of that scripture. But I like the verse number 17 just as much. Because the Bible goes on and says, for he sent not his son into the world to condemn. See, God is not going to condemn you where you are. He's not going to condemn you because you are having trouble walking this walk. He's not going to condemn you. He's not going to cast you out of his presence. He may not look on you while you're still having issues. He might turn his back for a minute until you repent. Okay. But the moment you repent, he'll turn right back around towards you. And he said, that's my son. That's my daughter. He's repenting. Now, devil, you get your hands off. He's mine. She's mine. Loose them and let them go. That's the power of the foundation that you have established in your heart on the word of God. You can say to that mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea. And that mountain has to move. Why? Because you're not talking your talk. You're talking his talk. And his words are spirit. And they are life. When you speak the word of God, they're full of the life and the nature of God. It will produce the... It will. I'm going to say it like this. It'll bring the kingdom of God on the scene.
Amen.
I know that for a fact. Hallelujah. And so when I look at this, then I see what God is saying to us. I see that God is trying to bring us to understand that the truth is what is most important to us right now. He said, because when you know the truth is going to make you free. Amen. The truth is going to make you free. And when you get free, he that the Son set free is what?
Free indeed.
Is free indeed. Glory to God. I thank God for what he's doing right now. Because the body of Christ is starting to wake up. The body of Christ is starting to understand that this is not just a fly-by-night message that God has given us. Because I see other people are starting to talk about this more and more. Other ministers is talking about it more and more. Amen. And other people, and they also started to talk about upon this rock I'll build my church. They started to talk about that more and more. Amen. Why? Because this is the message that God has spoken for the earth for this year. He wants them to understand that Christ is the revelation of who God is.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
Did you know that?
Yes.
Christ is the revelation of who God is. That's why to know Christ, you know God. Mm-hmm. And to know God, you'll know you because he was God that created you.
Glory.
And then gave you power to stand against the kingdom of darkness. When? In the Garden of Eden. When he created you, he gave you dominion over all the work of his hand. But your authority was sold out by high treason in the Garden of Eden. When Eve and Adam partaken of the tree of the fruit that God told them not to eat of.
Right.
He told them they were going to die as soon as they eat it. And the devil said, you'll not surely die. Well, naturally, they did not die immediately, but spiritually they died, and because they were spiritually dead, they was ran out of God's presence. They was ran out of the Garden of Eden. And that's why you're here today, because you're trying to get back what was lost in the garden. You're trying to get back your authority, you're trying to get back your power, you're trying to get back the ability to be the son or the daughter that God created you to be. See, you're supposed to reign in this life forever.
Amen.
But it got taken from you. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. My God. Are y'all getting anything out of this tonight?
Yeah.
Because I'm telling you, God is doing something here, and I'm just in awe of what He's doing. Amen. Now, I'm going right back right now to the book of Ephesians once again. Going back to the book of Ephesians, and I'm going back to chapter 6. Amen. Now, note again, because you see, God wants this buried in our spirit. He wants you to allow this to rest in your spirit, because as it begins to rest in your spirit, it's going to begin to minister to your heart. And as it begins to minister to your heart, you're going to begin to get stronger and stronger. Amen. You're going to begin to get stronger and stronger. Amen. So he tells us once again right here. He said, "Find my brother, be strong in the Lord." Amen. God doesn't want you to try to be strong in yourself. And He knows that you went to school. He knows that you have an education. He know all this about you. Mm-hmm. There's nothing about you He don't know. He knows those that don't have much education. But you know what? He's not intimidated. Neither one intimidate Him. Mm-hmm. Education or no education doesn't intimidate Him. Because God chose the foolish things of the world to confound the wise. Amen. Mm-hmm. Did he go find all the educated people to make disciples out of them? Mm-hmm. No, he went and found fishermen, uneducated men. Mm-hmm. And he had them to follow him. And he imparted to them the kingdom of God. Mm-hmm. Glory to God. He put some in you too, didn't he? Amen, amen. Glory to God. Amen. But God is showing us something, folks. He's showing us that there's a way that seems right to a man. But the end thereof is destruction. Yes. The end thereof is destruction. But he says right here in verse number 12 again, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God." You see, God wants you to understand verse number 12, because verse number 12 is the key to your breakthrough. The moment you begin to understand who you are, the moment you begin to not only understand who you are, but begin to declare who you are, amen, you're going to begin to break through. Your voice is going to become a sword. When you begin to pray, your voice is going to become a sword. When you begin to pray, and the principalities and the area that God have you to focus in on to pray over is going to be, you're going to find out, you're going to see that those things are going to begin to crumble over that area, over that region. Because see, this is why God wants us to, this is why God got us in spiritual warfare so long, because He's equipping us to begin to speak to the principalities and to the power. Because you are a spiritual weapon in the hand of God. Amen. That's why you need to understand that, because see, that's why He doesn't want you to be trying to be strong in yourself. The moment you understand that, you're going to begin to see that when you start praying, your prayer is going to go above the ceiling. Because right now, most of them just hit the top of the ceiling, falling back down. But if you get this, you're going to find yourself, when you begin to pray, it's just like the presence of God just encamped all around about you. You're going to feel His presence, and it's going to shake everything around you. And when you begin to pray, it's going to move heaven and earth. You're going to be called no things which be not as though they were, and all of heaven is going to take notice of it. Because you're not operating in your own strength, but you're operating on the strength and in the power of the Holy Ghost. God said that He will confirm the word with signs following. And before you know, when you're praying, you're going to know in your heart that your prayer got through. And then before you get done praying, somebody can call you and say, "Do you know this certain thing that just happened over here?" And you're going to realize that that's what I was just praying for. Hello. Whew. Change is in the atmosphere. The body of Christ is coming into an alignment with the kingdom of God. And as they come in alignment with the kingdom of God, the Spirit of God is going to release fresh importations. Fresh importations of the knowledge of who Christ is And he's going to give them the ability and the power to stand and to declare. And as you begin to stand and declare, you're going to see that God is going to confirm the word. You can be at work. And all of a sudden, someone, right out of the clear blue sky, walk up to you and say, please, can you just, you know what? I'm going through some changes right now. Okay. And I need something. I don't know what I need, but I need something. Then all of a sudden, you say, I know what you need. Mm-hmm. You need me to pray for you right now. And you take that person right aside, and you begin to pray, you begin to bind every demonic spirit that would have in trouble that person's mind, everything that will come against that person's mind, will, and emotion, you will begin to take a stand against it. Then all of a sudden, you're going to release your faith for the peace of God to get rest upon that person. Then all of a sudden, that person that was so disturbed is going to become so peaceful. They will say, wow.
Whatever was that?
See, you are the tool that God's going to use in these last days. Amen. You are the tool that God's going to use in these last days. God is going to bring you to a place of peace within. You. God's going to bring you into a place of peace within. Because until you have peace, you will never be able to release it. You got to receive it first. And once you receive it, you can release it. And when you release it, the people around you will know it. Because they're going to feel the power of God. And they're going to experience his love. Wow. That's powerful. God is good.
Yes,
amen.
Yes,
I'm stopping now. But I want you to know that God is looking at you. Each and every one of you. God is looking at you. And he's bringing you into a position where you will begin to be used by him. But the foundation must be settled in your spirit first. And then you're going to find out that God has been wanting to use you all along. The foundation must be settled in your spirit before you take that step. Because you take that step, and if you don't know what to do next, the devil's going to have you for lunch. You got to know that when you take that step, that you're taking a step not in your own strength, but in Christ. Yes. And once you take that step, remember, the Bible tells us in Mark chapter 16, verse number 20, the Lord working with them, confirming the word, with signs following. Mark 16, verse 20. The Lord working with them, confirming the word, with signs following. Amen. Father, I have delivered that what you placed upon my heart for today. I have declared. And now, Father, I'm asking you in the name of Jesus that you will show yourself strong on the behalf of your people. God, I worship you. I praise you. I glorify you. God, you want to establish in our hearts a sure foundation. A place where we can stand and know that we are in your presence. God, let the foundation begin to be laid now in heart of everyone under the sound of my voice. And let that what the enemy has meant for evil, let it be turned around, Father, so that your name will be glorified through it all. Yes. And Father, strengthen your people now. Mm-hmm. Strengthen them right where they are. Let the Spirit of the living God begin to penetrate every fiber of their being, bringing about your perfect will, your perfect plan for their lives. Father, I thank you now that your word will not return void, but it will accomplish that which you have sent it out to accomplish. And it will establish in the heart of your people the foundation that you desire them to stand on. And your name will be glorified, Father, because they put their trust in you. And God, I thank you for giving us the power to stand against the powers of darkness. You showed us how you made a show of them, triumphing over them openly in it. Now, Father, you have raised us up together with you. Help us to see ourselves in you and you in us. Help us to see ourselves as one. And God, we thank you for it in Jesus' name. We give you glory. We give you praise for it. Amen and amen. Well, amen. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. The thing stopped again, huh? Amen. So now let's go ahead and prepare for offering right now. Amen. Glory to God. Well, we got most of it after before we cut off this time. Glory to God. The Bible said, give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give unto your bosom. With what measure you meet withal, it shall be measured to you again. And the Bible said, he that soweth bountifully shall also reap bountifully. He that soweth sparingly shall also reap sparingly. For God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to make all grace abound toward you. You always having all sufficiency in all things, may abound to every good work. Amen. I need my checkbook. Glory to God. You that are sowing by the internet, you may go to my website, larryburgerministries.com. You may plant that seed of faith, amen, or you may give that tithe or that offering that you might want that the Lord put a place upon your heart, amen. But whatever you give, give from the heart, because God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray over this offering. We bless this offering, Father. God, you said when we give, it shall be given unto us, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give it to our bosom. We know your word is true, and we hold fast to your word. And Father, I pray for every person right now that support this ministry with their giving, with their tithes, with their offerings, and with their first fruit season, their first fruit seed. Father, I release my faith on their behalf, and I declare and decree, Father, in the name of Jesus, let every seed that has been sown in this ministry as of this year, Father, let the givers experience a bountiful return on the seed that they have sown. Let them see, know, and understand that this place where they have planted their seed is fertile ground, Father. And let that seed begin to germinate. Let it begin to grow. Let it begin to multiply back into their lives. Even now, Father, I thank you. That seed is growing up right now and being released back into their lives. And I thank you for it right now, Father, that it's coming back, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over as men give back into the bosom of those who are giving and supporting this ministry. Father, I speak a blessing over them right now. I cancel every demonic assignment against their finances and against their health. Now, Father, bless your people. I give you glory, praise, and honor for what you're doing in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Glory to God. If you're here today, you never made Jesus Christ Lord of your life. Maybe you have. But I know all of you here have already been saved. But I got to give this invitation because there may be some with us by the internet that has not given their heart to the Lord. They want to have that opportunity. So I'm going to give this invitation. It's not for your sake, for their sake. Maybe you want to rededicate your life to the Lord, and that's all well and good. God loves you. If that's why God brought you here, then that's good. Then you need to just do that. But right now, I want to minister to those who have never asked Jesus Christ into their heart. Those who always said, I got plenty of time. And their time is running out. And God is letting them know right now that their time is running out. And he's saying to you right now, today is the day of salvation. Why put off for today what you can do for tomorrow? Why put off until tomorrow what you can do for today? Amen. So say this prayer with me. Those of you that are rededicating your life, and those of you that just want a new beginning in your life, amen. And those of you that never said, ask Jesus in your heart before. Amen. I like to say this because when I say this, I mean it for my own self. I bring it right out of my own heart so it'll touch the heart of God. Amen. Father, say it with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, I repent of my sin. Forgive me, Lord. Come into my heart. Create in me a right spirit and renew in me a clean heart. Jesus, I believe that you are the Son of God, and yet you died for my sin. And as I confess my sin, you are faithful and just to forgive me of my sin and to cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I receive salvation. I receive deliverance. I receive healing right now in the name of Jesus. For all is a part of salvation. I receive it now. And Father, I thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. When I said that, I felt a tingle from the top of my head that went all down my back. The presence of God is strong, bro. Amen. Amen. And for you that want, that need prayer, you know, for you that said that prayer with me right now, I believe that God has touched you because I felt his presence just coming all over you like something I can't explain. But I know it was the presence of God, and I know that same presence is working on you right now where you are. And so, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for those who said that prayer. I pray for those, Father, who said it for the first time, and for those who said it for the number of times, Father, but this time they meant every word that they said. God, I'm asking you that you would visit them, strengthen them, empower them to be a greater witness for your kingdom and for your glory. And God, we thank you, and we say that it is done in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Glory to God. If you're here tonight, you need special prayer, I pray for you right now. Anyone need prayer, I pray for you right now. Amen. Come on, sister. You have a special request? Or? Okay. Amen. Amen. I'm going to use some of this. Oh, dear. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, you see my dear sister. You see her relationship with her spouse, her family. Father,
You see how the enemy is trying to interrupt it, trying to interfere. Now, Father, she's not running to the world for help. She's coming to you, her Father. And now, Father, I'm asking you that you would touch her, that you would strengthen her, that you would cause her to experience your goodness and your mercy in her relationship, Father. We break every demonic assignment that is at work against them. We cancel every argument in the spiritual realm over them. And we release the peace of God to begin to operate in them now in Jesus. In Jesus' name. Oh, Shiri, Mangarosa, Darabadere, Ekarabasatarabaki. And Father, we take a stand right now, a firm stand for righteousness' sake. Let Jesus Christ be exalted, and let the world be defeated in this relationship. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. Now, Father, I ask you to heal my dear sister's heart. Heal her heart, God. And then, Father, give her peace. Give her the will to stand when it seems like it's impossible sometimes. Oh, God, I thank you. Oh, my God, there it is. There it is. Oh, Sheila Bakaya. Whoa, Jesus. Jesus Christ. Thank you. Thank you. Fill a cup up now. Fill a cup up. Let it overflow. Let it overflow. In Jesus' name. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Praise you. Praise you. Father, let them lift it off a shoulder. Let me lift off a shoulder now in Jesus' name. God, you said to cast all our cares upon you in the name of Jesus. We take those cares off her right now. We lift them off her right now in the spiritual realm. We break them off her now in Jesus' name. Every weight and every sin that's easily been set before, we give it up. Release ourselves from it. In Jesus' name. God, we thank you. Holy Jesus. Holy Jesus. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. It's done. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Holy Jesus. Holy Jesus. You feel that presence all over you? I know you do. I know you do. Because he's here. He's here. He's here just for you. Glory to his name, Father. Glory to his name, Father. Glory to his name, Father.
God, you're healing the deep wounds right now. You're healing the hurts, the pains. You're healing right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. You're breaking off shackles. You're breaking off shackles in the name of Jesus. You're setting her free right now, Father. Every stronghold that the enemy have established, Father, every stronghold that the enemy has established, Father, God, you're bringing those shackles off of her right now. You're setting her free right now. Father, you set her mind at peace. You're giving her peace of mind right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, you're setting her free right now. You're setting her free right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. I declare that she's free, free, free in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Thank you for it, Father. Thank you for it, Father. Thank you for it, Father. Praise you, praise you, praise you. Praise you. Praise you, praise you. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Praise you. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Shaka malala basilo. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. She. Yes, Lord. Father, you're healing a broken heart right now. You're healing a broken heart right now. You're healing a broken heart right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. You're healing a broken heart right now. In the name of Jesus. There it is. 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 He's healing a broken heart right now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. The spirit of rejection, I break you off her now. I break you off now. Now in Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Praise you. Let the spirit of life that's in Christ Jesus raise her up, my Father. Let it raise her up. Let it establish her in Jesus' name. God, we thank you. We praise you. We praise you. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. We worship you. We worship you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. You receive that? Amen. Amen. So good to see my sister. It's all good. It's all good. So good to see you. May your God bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. And may he strengthen you for the days ahead, the days to come. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. There you go. Mm. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Next, let me pray for you, brother. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Father, in the name of the Father and Son and of the Holy Spirit. Father, in the name of Jesus, I release every demonic stronghold is trying to establish itself in my brother's heart and mind. I break the power of it right now. Every argument in the spiritual realm, I loose you from your assignment now in Jesus' name. Father, I release the peace of God as I pass of all understanding upon him, because God, you love him. You gave your life for him. Oh God, now Father, in the name of Jesus, I release that life to rise up within him. I pray, Father, that you will begin to do a healing in his heart. A healing in his heart. In his heart. His heart, God. The deep wounds that only he knows about. And you know about. God, heal those wounds right now. In Jesus' name. Oh, yeah, Lord. Yeah, Lord. Yeah, yeah. Those secret pains, Father, that only he experienced. God, you already know about it. Oh, God. Just touch him right now. In the name of Jesus. Show yourself strong on his behalf. Oh God, I thank you. Now, Father, restore. Restore everything that the locust, the cankerworm, the caterpillar, the palmworm, that great army have come against him and have eaten up. Father, restore to him everything that the devil stole from him. In the name of Jesus. Holy Shandelila Bangarosi. E karandera sabora posadara. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Korabasi. I see relationship, some kind of relationship that's been distorted. I don't know if this is healing coming for this in this area, or he's going to give you a new beginning in this area. But I see something that has happened in a relationship, and I see God want to bring you to a new area in that part of your life. Amen. If that means anything to you, I don't know, but only you and God know. But I'm just sharing with you what I'm sensing in my spirit. And I also sense that God wants to bring you to a place of inner peace. Inner peace. Stop blaming yourself for what took place. And just rest in God. And God's going to heal. He's going to restore. He's going to bring to pass all those things that you can't bring to pass in the natural. God is going to bring you to pass. God is going to heal. God is going to restore. Hallelujah. Now, Father, we thank you. I release that anointing now from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. May your kingdom come and your will be done, Father, in his heart and in his life. In Jesus' name. Now, Father, I declare and decree, Father, divine health and healing. Divine health and healing. I cancel everything, Father, that will come against itself, whether it be a germ, a virus, or a touch,
that have attached itself to his body, Father, I cancel it in the spiritual realm, and I loose it from his assignment right now. And I release the peace and the life and the nature of God to drive it out, and that it will affect no one else in this household. In Jesus' name, amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Did that make any sense to you about relationships, son?
Yeah.
It did?
Yeah.
Amen. I knew I'm hearing him.
Yeah. That's right on track.
Right on track. I like that. Amen. God bless you. We love you, man.
Too. Thank you.
Amen. Anybody else want prayer? You want prayer? Cocorosa? Okay. Okay.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for my brother, Lord God. I thank you that your hand continue to rest upon him. I thank you for the peace that's a passive all understanding will keep his heart and his mind. I cancel everything, Father, that will come against his household. Everything that is not from you, Lord God, I cancel it in the spiritual realm. And I release the anointing, the peace of God that's a passive all understanding upon him right now, Father. And God, I give you all the praise and all the glory for what you're going to do. And Father, for what you are currently doing.
Yes.
Thank you, Father, for it right now. And Father, give his daughter peace. And give her the strength to endure. To go forward with her life. In Jesus' name. I thank you for it. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Now, Father, we pray for all those that are with us by the internet. We pray, Father, we release the anointing upon them. Everything that the devil has did, Father, try to discourage them, try to bring them to a place of helplessness, Father. We rebuke it off of them right now in Jesus' name. And, Father, we release the peace of God that surpasses all understanding that will keep them, Father, their hearts and their mind in perfect peace. God, I bless them and I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Now, Father, touch them right now. Shaka Messiah. Let this word not fall to the ground, Father, but let it penetrate every heart under the sound of my voice. I thank you and I bless you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, God bless you all. We thank God for each and every one of you. Thank you for joining us today. Don't forget to join us again this coming Sunday. Amen. We're going to have a word that's going to bless your heart just going to your heart to start jumping and shouting on the inside of your chest. You're going to start thinking you're something going on, though. But it's not. It's just going to be your heart rejoicing. That's all. It's just going to be rejoicing because of the Holy Ghost going to be moving. Amen. We're going to get back on our subject. Amen. On Sunday, upon this rock, I'll build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And we want you to be a part of this because God wants to impart something in your heart through this message. We love you. Until then, God bless you. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.